Yeah, so my trip in Japan has come to an end. It's been pretty crazy living in both countries, Australia and Japan. I still get a lot of reverse culture shocks coming back here, believe it or not. I've been really used to living in Australia, as weird as it is, having been away so long and then, you know, getting used to life back there. But it's fucking awesome, and I think I took a lot for granted when I lived here in Japan. People are fucking weird here sometimes, you know, there's a lot of creepy people. And people can be weird in Australia too, a lot of bogans, just what you call hobos or chavs. So maybe it's just me, maybe everyone's normal and cool and I'm just fucked, but I don't believe that. I had a sick time here. I got here and it was like late 30s in terms of temperature in Australia, so that's like high 80s or 90s actually. And when I got here it was fucking 2 degrees. It was snowing the first couple of days, it was freezing. Anyway, I came straight from the airport, straight here to training, taught a class, and then a meeting and stuff as usual. And then the next day I went to Chiba and taught at one of our branches there, and that was really cool. But it was like a Friday midday seminar. I'm thinking like, who the fuck's gonna show up, you know? And it was a good turnout, a really good turnout, because they're all like leaders of companies or like scientists or like, you know, ballers basically, you know, like big shots. Anyway, that was awesome. Really good turnout, really fun. Had a lot of fun with those guys as always. The next day I came back here and taught a SILAT intensive course on the Saturday and Sunday. And then throughout the week, we caught up on a lot of extra training, and I jumped in on the regular classes and you know, taught a lot of different drills and had a really good time there. And just caught up on a lot of you know, filming that we had to do for the online learning centers and the ITP program that people are doing, the online instructor development program. Before I go throughout Australia to see them this month, actually, I'm heading to Perth, Sydney, Melbourne, Brisbane, and Auckland too, actually, which isn't a part of Australia, but it may as well be. And then the month after that, in April, we've got, what is it, the US tour. So I'll be in Hawaii first, LA, Miami, then back to LA. So that'll be cool, looking forward to that. Then I went to Kobe, I finished up here and then went to Kobe. Had to be up really early in the morning. That was as fun as a kick in the sack.
It's 25 past 7 in the morning. I'm about to leave for the bullet train to Tokyo and then Tokyo to Kobe and teach there for a couple of days. So yeah, that's why I look like shit ran over twice. Should be a good trip. I like the bullet train, it's way better than planes and shit, so yeah.
As soon as I got there, I went straight to our branch in Kobe, and we had guys from Osaka, both Kobe branches, base branches, and then one of our guys from Fukuoka as well. I was doing Tai Chi with him on the side, that was cool. That's been really good. I've been sharing Tai Chi with him for about 5 or 6 years now. He's doing really well. And yeah, that was awesome fun. It was really good times. We had people come to Kobe from all over the country, like literally the other end. Which takes a 3 hour bullet train ride, which would usually be fucking 7-8 hours by car. We had guys come from this end that followed me there. We had guys come from that end as well. And we had guys from all around Kansai and even the Aichi Mie prefecture as well. So quite a few places. That was cool. That was really fun. The success of these books has been really helpful. This one came out in December last year. This one came out the year before, I think in August, and that just sold out like 3 or 4 times. This one's doing really well, so a lot of people have been coming to our other branches. That's been really helpful. During the week that I'm here, what I always try and do is, because everything's such a clusterfuck, I try and get as much time in for self-development as I can. I still try and make a lot of time for that. It is hard, because in this position that I'm in, I have to be considerate of others. It's like the opposite of being a fighter. You know, you have to, not thinking that the world revolves around you, but quite the opposite. You have to revolve your life around people's progression and standards and maintaining standards and communication with your team and so forth and so on. So yeah, it's quite interesting. But yeah, so after they leave, they might get out of here by 11, and then I'll be here for an hour or so doing a workout. Some nights, even if I can only get half an hour, I'll still do it. You know, I'll just get into it. As often as I can, I'll also make time to make sure that I get to the temple and just refresh and just, you know, do my meditation and my offerings and all those things. So I like to make the time to make sure that I can get there and do what I feel that's necessary for me to stay focused and have clarity, and also gives me that type of mental endurance. There's no other you know, fucking supplement that'll help me do that, so.
Got off the train from Kobe, and I'm here at Holloway studio with Manu here. He's from Germany. Where are you, Manu?
There you are.
He's doing some photos for Holloway's new book coming out this year, because it's her 20th year anniversary of tattooing. So we're going to do a bit of a shoot, and I'm going to get some more ink, try and finish this off best we can tonight, and Boss is here keeping guard over my shit. Cool of him as always. So. Finishing getting inked at about 5 a.m. or so, and then got home by about 6:30, whatever it was. And then I got to bed at like 7:30 after doing some washing and cleaning up my house and shit. And then there's some fucking construction going on next door and outside in two different places, believe it or not. And I'm just like, you gotta be fucking kidding me. And then I get a phone call from someone. I'm just like, dude, why? The only shit thing about this is that it's like 7 degrees outside. In America, that's like 44, but last night it was less than half that. It's actually not too bad tonight, you know, because I don't know, it's a bit of humidity's coming or whatever the fuck happens with the weather, but last night was ridiculous. I just wish it would snow, because it's a little bit more comfortable, and I guess it's exciting, but you know, coming from Australia where it was like fuck 40 degrees, like, so I don't know, in the high 90s, I guess that's probably something like that in Fahrenheit anyway. You know, chilling on the beach or going to waterfall and hanging out, from coming back to here and just going, fuck. Most annoying thing is having to put on all these layers, but it's worth it. I had a good time with my guys tonight at training. It's been fucking awesome. One of the guys was crying that I was leaving us. It's actually quite, not just flattering, but very heartwarming for me, because, you know, they're very excited to see me. They take time off work to come in, and they travel from interstate.
Anyway, it's been a really cool trip. It's been interesting. It's been very interesting. A lot of crazy shit always happens, as it always does in my life, but I figured I'd put this video together just as a bit of an insight as to a day in the life of me. You know, I think people might be a little bit curious. They just see videos pop up from being in different places, but it's always like this. It's always like inside a gym or whatever, so it's not that interesting. But yeah, there's a lot to it, and there's a lot of great experiences made along the way, and always meet a lot of great people, and I'm often, quite often, tested by the powers that be, whatever they are, and yeah, makes life interesting. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this, and make sure you check out my other channel, Luke Holloway TV, about Japan Life 101 and realism, because I just share all the fuckery, whether it's good or bad, I don't care. I'm just, you know, I find it all interesting. I find it all opportunities to learn and grow. Some I have bad reactions to, and I still reflect on it later and go, fuck, I was real kind, you know. But yeah, definitely check out that channel, because it's got, you know, shit from the last 12, 13 years actually of being here. So, you know, now I am back and forth as usual. Even when I was living here, I was back and forth. But yeah, I'm still putting content up on that and, you know, trying to keep it as interesting as possible, because I believe life is interesting. So anyway, definitely check that out. And if you haven't already, subscribe. Cheers.